us as we come into his glory. Ask that you join us. 1 James chapter 3, verses 5 through 10. Again, 1 James chapter 3, verses 5 through 10. Listen for the word of the Lord. And Gideon, the Lord appeared to Saul in a dream by night. God said, ask what I should give you. And Solomon said, you have shown great and steadfast love to your servant, my father David, because he walked before you in faithfulness, in righteousness, in uprightness, heart toward you, and you have kept for him this great and steadfast love. You have given him a son to sit on his throne today. And now, O Lord, my God, you have made your servant king in place of my father David. Although I am only a little child, I do not know how to go out or come in. And your servant is in the midst of the people whom you have chosen, a great people, so numerous that they cannot be numbered or counted. Give your servant, therefore, an understanding mind to govern your people, able to discern between good and evil. For who can govern this, your great people? It pleased the Lord that Solomon had asked this. This is the word of God for the people of God. Now, I want to use some time here on this day, prayer, and that moves God. Prayer is our means to communicate with God. And it's through prayer God is made available to us at any time. Yet many still fail to see the seriousness and the power of prayer today. Prayer has been taken out of school and we have more problems. Charles Converts wrote in 1868 these words, "What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and grief to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear, all because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. What would happen in the churches if each member took prayer seriously, prayed daily for each member, talked to God daily, and prayed for ministries and organizations in the church? Prayer empowers us as well as keeps us in God's will. Jesus reminded us of this when he said, not my will, Lord, but let thy will be done. Only humans have been given the ability to talk with God. And if we cannot say a word, we can wave our hand. In this text, God begins the conversation with Solomon. And God says to Solomon, ask what I should give you. And note, Solomon begins his prayer with praise. God tells Solomon, you have been good to my father David, and God, you've been good to me. You've given me this position. Solomon thanks God for yesterday and today. Solomon takes note of how God has blessed him in the past and the present. Now third, King Solomon in his prayer tells God, I am only a little child. When we pray, we come to God like a little child. Though you might be an adult, you may have status, you may have achievements, you come before God like a little child. Solomon says, I do not know how to go out or come in. In other words, Lord, there are some simple things that I do not know how to do well. Lord, I need your help to do some simple things better in my life. Lord, I am a little child. I'm like a child here. I need your help. I need your guidance. I do not know what I'm doing. When we communicate with God truthfully about where we are in life, God will respond to them. God tells Solomon to ask him for something, and in verse 9, Solomon asks that God give him an understanding mind to govern your people and able to discern between good and evil. In other words, Lord, give me wisdom. There are many who know what is right, but may not do it. And we see evidence of this now here in our nation, here in our world, here for the past few days and the past few days around the world. We find the world has been shown evidence over decades. The world has seen and understood what is right, but has failed to do right. And now, for the last few days, men and women, boys and girls, black and white, have moved to the streets to protest, to say what's right and what's wrong. And the time has come that we who are people, even in the church must stop playing church, and the church must come to the realization at the same forefront. Notice when Solomon said this, it pleased the Lord that the Lord hear. Here asks in verse 10, this prayer moved God. We talk to God truthfully to let him know where we are with him. Our prayer will move God. When God moves, things happen on our behalf. God tells Solomon, because you have not asked for a long life or riches or for the life of your enemies, God tells Solomon, I'm going to give you what you have asked of me. Solomon asked God to help him in a position that God placed him on the journey. God is ready to bless Solomon more than he realized or asked. will change your attitude. When your attitude changes, you can pour out your soul to Him and not pretend. Prayer will move God, man. When God moves on your behalf, get ready to be blessed. God tells Solomon, I'm going to give you what you have asked. But then look at the 13th. God is going to give him both riches and honor. God is going to also give him what he did not ask. No other king shall compare with him. God will set you apart from others. If God moves, get ready for your blessing. Because in verse 14, Solomon, if you will walk in my ways and keep my statutes and my commandments as your father David walked, then I will lengthen your life. I don't know about you, but I want God to move in my life. And if God moves, no weapon formed against us shall ever prosper. That's the story. That's the ticket. That when you pray and pray from your heart, that prayer will evidently move God. We find evidence here. And I submit to you that there ought to be more of us who can tell our story. That God still answers prayer. Will you pray with me? Dear Lord, as we come now in this time, there are many of us who can tell our story that you're still answering prayer. Many who can testify at the fact I've been sick, so sick. I can testify that you heal my body. Many who can testify that they had to turn to the wall to talk to you. And in turn, Lord, by and by, you answered their prayer. So we who are here, who assemble far and near, we're living testimonies that you still answer prayer. And we're so glad about it. And on this day, we ought to pick up the phone and call somebody and be excited to say, I'm one in the number who can testify that the Lord answered my prayer. And so, Lord, we say thank you. It is done. For it is in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. We kind of bless. We ask and say to you, continue to be safe in all that you do. Continue to be safe until we shall meet again, this time, same time.